Oh, hello everyone, and welcome back to Chemist Tea Time. Last lesson, we learned about some trends in the periodic table. Now let's tie them into ionization energy, which is the energy that is required to remove a single electron from an atom in the gas phase. The result of removing an electron from an atom results in the formation of an ion, which is a chemically charged species. When we remove an electron, an atom becomes more positive, thus forming a cation, which is a positively charged ion. When dealing with ionization energies, it is important to note that these energies are always positive because we are applying energy to remove an electron. The more energy that is applied, the harder it is to remove an electron, and vice versa. The energy associated to removing the first electron is known as the first ionization energy. Let me ask you a question. Do you think we can remove more than one electron from an atom? Well, if you said yes, then you are right. The energy required to remove two electrons is known as the second ionization energy, and so forth. Let's focus for now on the first ionization energy. Let's look at this table that displays the first ionization energies for the main group and transition elements. What I want us to do is focus on the main group elements, and let's see if we are able to notice a trend in these energies. As we move from left to right across the periodic table, we see an increase in ionization energies. But if you look closer, you see some sudden decreases in these energies, such as in the case of boron and oxygen, and among others. You must be wondering why this is the case. Well, in order to understand this, we need to first talk about the stability of orbitals and effective nuclear charge. Let's look at the electron configuration for boron, which is helium 2s2 2p1. Even though boron has a large effective nuclear charge in comparison to beryllium, because it has an additional proton, the p orbital is further away from the nucleus and is not able to penetrate nearly as well as the electron in the s orbital. Penetration is the ability of an electron to get closer to the nucleus. Also, if boron was to lose an electron, it would have a completely filled s orbital, which is more stable than a partially filled orbital. The electron for configuration for boron, if we were to remove an electron, would be helium 2s2, making it a boron cation, which would be denoted as B+. In the case of oxygen, it has a dip in ionization energy as well. This can be explained by looking at the electron configuration, which is helium 2s2 2p4. If we were to remove an electron from the p orbital, it would actually reduce the electron-electron repulsion because it would become a half-filled p orbital. The electron configuration would become helium 2s2 2p3, making it an oxygen cation. An important note to make at this point is this trend is seen throughout these groups because they have the same valence electrons. Ionization energies also decrease as you go down the periodic table, because if we think about the distance the electrons are from the nucleus, as you move down the group, the atomic radius also increases. Consequently, the further electrons are from the nucleus, they are held less tightly, thus making them have lower ionization energies. As a recap, the lower the ionization energy, the easier it is to remove the electron, whereas the higher the ionization energy, the harder it is to remove. As mentioned previously, you can have multiple ionization energies, meaning you can remove multiple electrons. What we begin to notice is there are trends in the second, third, etc. ionization energies, which can all be explained by the stability and electron configurations. Remember, a half-filled orbital is more stable than a partially filled orbital, such as in the case with oxygen. Also, a fully filled orbital is more stable than a partially filled orbital, such as with boron. If we focus on the second ionization energy for magnesium, we see that it is significantly lower in energy than sodium. Well, this is a result of multiple facets, such as if we remove two electrons from magnesium, it becomes isoelectronic with neon. Whereas if we try to remove two electrons from sodium, you begin to remove core electrons, which requires a lot of energy. It is important to begin to understand these trends and what causes them. We went over a lot of new topics today. Please make sure to re-watch this video if you think you might have missed a concept. Also, it is important to make sure you review the worked out problems because they put into action the topics covered. Once again, thank you for tuning into Chemist Tea Time, and I look forward to our next lesson. Have a wonderful day.